Uganda is one of the many countries that has faced challenges with climate change, and according to experts, this is as a result of environmental degradation and cutting down of trees, hence leading to floods, famine, global warming, among others. Uganda has approximately 506 forests located in various parts of the country, measuring to 3 million acres, 12,657.47 kilometers, equivalent to 6.3%. But as we speak, 13% of the forest land has been degraded. Western districts such as Koboko and Yumbe, being host communities to a large number of refugees, they highly depend on forests, leading to continuous dependence on charcoal and fire for cooking.
We have got laws governing the management of these central forest reserves. So we expect our team to operate within the existing forestry policies and laws, so that nobody can, assume to be above the law.
In a bid to cut down the vice of deforestation and environmental degradation, non-government organizations like the European Union, Wild Conservation Society, and Uganda Biodiversity, through their program Restoring and Conserving Degraded Ecosystems, have donated new technology called Smart Tool Application to help in forest monitoring.
So we build these synergies to ensure that the forests are effectively and efficiently managed for the benefit of all of us as a country and globally, because forest has got several benefits, and these benefits go beyond Ugandan borders.
According to Nyeko, this new technology will ease their work of supervision and to know the activities that take place within the forests. Akule Patrick and John Bosco Muruli, responsible for the Ozubu Central Forest Reserve, found in Koboko District, says they are very happy about this very technology given to them to monitor the forests.
Other proposals that are coming in terms of strengthening the patrol teams, not only in terms of the technology, because we are also looking at the infrastructure development, things like forest stations. If we can have forest stations, the field teams would be on site to manage these forest reserves. So with the technology there and the people being on site, we should be able to improve the management of these CFRs.
Levand Turiom Rigendo, the project manager of Restoring and Conserving Degraded Ecosystem in Uganda Biodiversity Fund, has outlined the objectives of this project.
For purposes of bringing back the forest after NFA removing the people in those encroached areas. So the role of WCS is not to evict people, but to plant trees in the areas that where people have been evicted.
Story compiled by Adrian Bali Bwanika for the news.